systems are household water treatment systems that are used in a lot of developing countries. The way they work is you have a filter that is filled with sand, and as you pour natural water through it, a biofilm naturally develops. And this biofilm has bacteria that consumes other pathogens in the water. So this is very useful for developing countries, especially in isolated communities, because they don't require a whole lot of maintenance after they've been constructed. The implementation process can be a lot pretty labor intensive. And one of the issues is if they don't have access to the materials that it can be difficult to build them with the recommended materials. So what we're looking at is comparing high-end filters that are built with beach sand, which is the recommended sand, as opposed to river sand, which were our test filters. So we had six filters with river sand, and then two as our controls with beach sand. And of the six filters that river sand, half of them were treated with chlorine, and half of them were untreated. So we're also looking at if the river sand biosand filters could be disinfected. I got some river sand from a local creek bed and melted these filters, and then we also looked at E. coli and turbidity from mold to compare them.
So turbidity is important because pathogens tend to adhere to the particulates that form turbidity. So the World Health Organization recommends a drinking water standard of less than 1 NTU. For our filters, we filled with an NTU between 15 and 25, which is much higher than you see in the field. It's recommended that before people in developing countries run water through the filters, that they filter it with a cloth filter in order to remove some of the turbidity prior to going into the filter to prevent backup. So we decided to go with 15 to 25, even though it's much higher, because we wanted to test the percentage removal of turbidity that these filters are capable of handling. So for the E. coli, we spiked our filters with 10 to the 6 colony-forming units from 100 milliliters of influent. Biosand filters work like plug flow reactors. So say I put water in the filter today, what would come out of the filter would be what I put in yesterday. So whenever we spike the filters with E. coli, we test the sample the following day. So we test the effluent from the next day after the spike, which is called effluent day one. And then we run this as well as effluent day two, which is 2 days after the spike. And we run these samples through a process called membrane filtration, where we are able to determine how many colonies form, and then we compare these colonies to how many colonies were in the influent, and that's how we get this percent reduction of total coliform breath that Michelle will go into detail.